Hello, air cooling aficionados. This is part two of my Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro 4 review video when used together with Intel's Core i7-13700K CPU. In the first part, I tested the loudness of the Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro 4 CPU fans at the max turbo power of 253 watts of the CPU. Therefore, the long and short term limits, aka PL1 and PL2, in the BIOS were configured to 253. The conclusion was that the Dark Rock Pro 4 handles everyday workloads just fine, and with low noise. At particular sustained multi-core workloads, the Tjunction temperature of 100 degrees Celsius was reached quickly. This begs the question what we can do about it. In this video, I will show how different CPU power limits and temperature limits impact the temperatures of the CPU when used together with the Dark Rock Pro 4. With that information, I will show to which conclusion I came and which I found to be the best compromise between performance, loudness, and temperatures. Please note that all of the results I will be presenting are done with OBS, LibreOffice, Task Manager, and a handful more tools running in the background. If you find this type of content helpful, I'd be very thankful if you'd leave me a like and hit subscribe. I bought all of the components you will see in this video for my private 2023 PC build from my own money. Therefore, you can expect my own opinion without any financial influence. One quick thing first. Fairly early in my testing, I found that the factory case fans positions of the Purebase 500DX case fans with one of the fans at the top of the case did not help that much. It did not produce any notable airflow. Therefore, I repositioned the front fan so that I could move the one from the top also to the front. I don't really know if this helps the airflow, but you should know that if you are planning to use the Purebase 500DX as well. Let's have a quick look at the actual product specifications of Intel's Core i7-13700K. Here we see that its max turbo frequency is 5.4 GHz. To my understanding, this is only true for one or two cores during single-core workloads. When running multi-core workloads, the max turbo frequency of the performance cores is 5.3 GHz. The efficiency cores max turbo frequency is 4.2 GHz. The processor base power is 125 watts. The maximum turbo power is 253 watts. Tjunction, which is the maximum temperature allowed at the processor die, is 100 degrees Celsius. Sometimes you read the term Tjmax, which I believe is this value. Now let's gain some basic understanding of the power limits on Intel's 13th gen processors. In Intel's 13th gen processors datasheet, I found this explanation of the power levels. The power limit 1 is a threshold for average power that will not exceed. It is recommended to be set equal to processor base power, aka TDP. PL1 should not be set higher than thermal solution cooling limits. Power limit 2 is a threshold that, if exceeded, the PL2 rapid power limiting algorithms will attempt to limit the spike above PL2. In this diagram, we see that the PL2 limit can be sustained for up to 100 seconds. The PL1 could be sustained forever, provided that the cooling solution's thermal limits are sufficient. According to Intel's webpage, informations about temperature for Intel processors, Intel processors have internal thermal control mechanisms to reduce power and limit temperature to prevent overheating. But it also says that the system builder and do-it-yourself end user should design platform configurations to keep the processor under the Tjunction max threshold during heavy workloads to maximize performance of the system. This raises the question what the cooling capacity of the thermal solution named Dark Rock Pro 4 and three Pure Wings 2 140mm case fans actually is. So let's play System Builder and find out. By the end of this video, we will have a clear understanding of the limits and the options. For that, I did a set of Cinebench R23 single and multi-core runs at different power limits and different thermal limits to find out what the results will be. First, let's check if the limits have any effect on the single core results. I did the first set of runs with different long duration power limits PL1 and short duration power limits PL2 by setting them to different combinations of 253, 230, 200, 190, 180 and 125 watts. After that I set it back to 253 and changed the thermal limits to 95 degrees Celsius, 90 degrees Celsius and 85 degrees Celsius. These were the results for Cinebench R23 single core benchmarks. Here we see 4 bars per combination of PL1, PL2 and Tjunction. From all the runs, I decided to focus on the PL1 limits of 253, 190 and 125 watts. PL2 is always set to 253 watts. The T-junction was left at the default value, which is 100 degrees Celsius. In the last two runs, I tested with PL1 and PL2 set to 253 watts, but I set the overheating temperature protection to 90 and 85 degrees Celsius, which I assume is the setting in which we can set a custom T-junction temperature to a lower level than from the manufacturer. The bars for each benchmark run represent from top to bottom Cinebench score, average CPU package temperature in degrees Celsius, average package power in watts, average CPU fan noise in decibels. For my methodology of measuring the noise, please check out part 1 of this review. All of this was done at a room temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. The diagram gives it away immediately. The Cinebench single core results are more or less the same, around 1975 points, mostly independent of any power or temperature limits. Now for the interesting part, let's look at the Cinebench R23 Multi Core benchmark results. This diagram is designed like the last one, only this time with more PL1, PL2 and T-junction combinations. I sorted the results by the Cinebench multi-core benchmark results in descending order. The first run up at the top was with PL1 and PL2 both set to 253 watts and T-junction left at the default of 100 degrees Celsius. It resulted in the highest Cinebench score of 28,873. As expected, the average CPU package temperature shows 99 degrees Celsius. As with the multi-core load without any particular limit, the CPU was not limited until it hit the junction of 100 degrees Celsius, and then the internal thermal control mechanisms began thermal throttling the CPU a little. As a result, the CPU fan ran at max RPM, which resulted in 33.7 decibels. In the fourth result line with PL1 of 190 watts, PL2 of 253 watts, and the junction of 100 degrees Celsius, we see two bars for average CPU package temperature and two for average CPU package power. This is due to the fact that the PL1 and PL2 power limits were different in that run. The average package power for when PL2 power limit was active was 218 watts and resulted in 96 degrees Celsius average package temperature. After around 100 seconds, PL1 of 190 watts became active for the rest of the benchmark run. This resulted in an average package power of 190 watts and an average package temperature of 88 degrees Celsius while power limit PL1 was active. This led to 33.7 dB from the CPU fans and a Cinebench result of 28,025 points, which is only 3% lower than the highest result. During the PL1, the P cores clocked at an average of 4.9 GHz and the E cores at an average of 3.9 GHz. I find the setting very interesting, as the long time CPU temperature was 88 degrees Celsius and therefore notably lower than T-junction. But remember, this temperature was achieved at a room temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. And therein lies the problem. Now it is in the middle of the winter and I am heating my place to a comfy 20 degrees Celsius. But in the middle of the summer, the temperature in my home is easily 10 degrees higher and closer to 30 degrees Celsius. This would result in thermal throttling during PL2 and probably result in a PL1 temperature closer to 98 degrees Celsius. So let's check out the result line number 7 with power limits PL1 of 125 watts and PL2 of 253 watts. Like in the product specification, to understand the numbers as intended by Intel's product specification of the 13700K. First, we see that the PL2 package power is 225 watts for around 41 seconds. During that time, the average CPU package temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. The P cores clock at around 5.1 GHz and the E cores at around 4 GHz. After that, the PL1 power limit of 125 watts kicks in. This leads to 124 watts average CPU package power and an average CPU package temperature of 71 degrees Celsius. In that state, the P cores clock notably lower at 4.3 to 4.4 GHz and the E cores at 3.4 GHz. The lower power consumption leads to less heat and therefore lower CPU fan speeds and a loudness of 27.2 decibels. The result is considerably lower as well, with 24,887 points, which is 13.8% lower than with the highest temperatures. But on the other hand, the loudness is 20% lower, or 6.5 decibels in absolute numbers. I also did multiple runs with a lower T-junction temperature, for example with 90 degrees Celsius and PL1 and PL2 set to 253 watts, as you can see in result line number 3. This resulted in 28,064 points, which is 2.8% lower than the highest score. With that setup, the average CPU package power was 199 watts. This has the advantage that the temperature will never go higher than 90 degrees Celsius, even with higher environment temperatures. The cost for that was that the peak cost clocked at lower frequencies of 4.8 to 4.9 GHz, and the e-cost between 3.9 and 4.0 GHz. This somewhat limits the top speed but ensures lower peak temperatures. You could go even lower by setting the T-junction to 85 degrees Celsius. For me, this resulted in 27,454 points, which is close to 5% less than the top score. The average power was 180 watts. The peak cost clocked at around 4.8 GHz and the e-cost at around 3.8 GHz. I find setup number 4 kind of okay, so I decided to continue with PL1 of 190 watts and PL2 of 253 watts. With T-junction of 100 degrees Celsius. Remember that this is at 20 degrees Celsius room temperature and with the Be Quiet Pure Wings 2 fans of the Purebase 500DX case. But as this results only show the CPU fan noise based on the CPU fan RPMs and no system noise was considered, this does not make any difference. After doing all of the benchmarks, I replaced the Pure Wings 2 fans with 3 Silent Wings 4 140mm high speed fans and capped their fan curves at 1250 RPMs, which lowered the whole system noise by 2 to 3 dBs. Again, this did not influence the CPU fan noise in any way. Next, I compared the 7-SIP Blender Cinebench Single and Multi Core and CPU-Z benchmarks for PL1 of 253 watts with PL1 of 190 watts. The 190 watt results are represented by the red bars, the 250 watts are the blue bars. As we see in this diagram, there is not much difference between the different runs except the Cinebench Multi-Core benchmark. It is 3% lower at PL1 with 190 watts, as we already saw in the last chart. Lastly, let's check the FPS scores for Red Dead Redemption 2 and Watch Dogs Legion at 720p and 4K. For a detailed setup of these benchmarks, check out my first part of this video. Again, the 190 watts results are red and the 253 watts are blue. Long story short, a PL1 power limit of 190 watts seems not to put any noticeable toll on the FPS, except around 3.7% lower FPS at the 4K benchmarks. The Red Dead Redemption 2 benchmark at 720p did seem to have even higher FPS, but this could be an error on my part as well. In this video, we saw that without any power limits, the CPU hits the thermal limit T-junction of 100 degrees Celsius at long-lasting multi-core workloads, which results in high overall CPU temperatures when used with Be Quiet's Darkrock Pro 4. This mustn't be bad, as Intel's processor have internal thermal control mechanisms to reduce power and limit temperatures to prevent overheating. As a system builder, we should aim for lower temperatures though. Lowering either PL1, for example to 180 or 190 watts, or lowering T-junction, if you can on your motherboard, leads to noticeably lower temperatures in such workloads without losing a lot of compute power. This also probably raises the system's long-term stability and reliability. These tests were made with the Be Quiet Darkrock Pro 4 in Be Quiet's Purebase 500DX case with 3 built-in Pure Wings 2 140mm case fans. After recording this and the part 1 of this video, I decided to replace the Pure Wings 2 with Silent Wings 4 fans. This lowered the system noise but did not have any notable impact on the CPU fan noise and only little impact on the CPU performance. I changed the fan curves of the Silent Wings and kept their max RPM to around 1250. If you got value from this video, consider liking and subscribing. If you don't like it or you have questions or suggestions, please write me a comment. I am the Tech Wombat. Thank you for watching, take care and goodbye.